Hello students, in our today's class, let us study about the new chapter, Our Body, A Wonderful Machine, lesson number 13. So in this chapter, you are going to study about main organs of our body and the functions of those organs in human body. And also you are studying about some habits of cleanliness to keep these organs healthy. So you are studying healthy habits. Now, in your previous classes, you have studied about sense organs. How many sense organs do we have? Yes, we have 5 sense organs. Yes. So which are those sense organs? Eye, ear, nose, tongue, skin. Right? So you see here, there is a match the following. In column A, they have given the sense organs, and in column B, it is the functions of those sense organs. So let us match the organs with their functions. Eye, what is the function of eye? Function of eye is to see things. To see things. Ear, what is the function of ear? To hear sound. What is the function of nose? Nose, to smell. What is the function of tongue? To taste. What is the function of skin? To feel heat or cold. To feel heat or cold. These organs are situated outside the body and we can see them. But in human body, there are many organs inside our body and we cannot see them. So let us learn about them. See, you cannot see the muscles and bones in our body, right? Which, because they are covered by our skin. The skin protects our body. Bones and muscles together shape our body. So what are the main functions of our body? What are the main functions of our body? Yes, there are many functions like respiration, excretion, digestion, right? So let us study one by one in this chapter. So one of the main functions of our body is respiration. Respiration. Look at this picture. Air enters your body through some organs and in the same path it comes out. So the hand on the chest feels the rise and fall. The path and the organ in which the air passes are shown in the picture. You see here. Our body needs oxygen, right? Our body needs oxygen that is present in the air. When we breathe, the lungs absorb the oxygen. So the oxygen from our nose goes inside. The air from the nose goes inside. And the oxygen present in the air is absorbed by the lungs. When we breathe, the lungs absorb the oxygen from the air. And the carbon dioxide, which is not needed to our body, goes out. Okay? The carbon dioxide which is not required by the body comes out. So the process of taking in oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide is called as respiration. See here, the process of taking oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide is called as respiration. So now tell me, what are the healthy habits that we have to practice for proper respiration? What are the healthy habits for proper respiration? So let us learn them one by one. Clean your nose regularly when you take bath. So only when you take bath, you have to clean your nose. So putting your finger inside your nose every now and then might cause some kind of allergies or pain, okay, in your nose. So do not cover your face while sleeping. It causes the problem of respiration, okay. When you are moving in the place of dust, take care to avoid dust entering your nose. So wearing a mask can avoid the dust entering inside your nose. So wear the mask. Do not be in a hurry while eating the food and drinking the water. What happens, it might get stuck near your throat, okay, that causes a severe problem. Do not expose yourself to smoke. If you smoke, what happens? Smoke is nothing but the impure air or the bad air. If that enters inside your body, that causes various problems, health issues like cancer. At least once in a day, sit straight and take deep breaths for 10 times as we do in our school, right? Morning, what we do yoga, yes? You have to sit straight and you have to take deep breaths, okay? Do not put things such as stick, pen, pieces of chalk, etc. into your nose. That might get hurt, causes bleeding, okay? So do not breathe through your mouth. So avoid breathing through your mouth. Cover your mouth with handkerchief while coughing or sneezing. The germs can be avoided from entering the air if you are suffering from cold and cough. These avoid the spreading of cold and cough to others. So if you have cough or sneezing, you have to just cover your mouth and nose with a handkerchief. Okay. What happens if you don't cover it? The germs that comes out when you cough or sneeze might transfer to the other person, and the person who is in front of you might be affected by coughing, sneezing, fever, etc. Observe this picture, write its name here. What is it? It is heart, right? It is heart. You have seen the discharge of blood when the body is injured. What is the color of the blood? It is red. So, do you know the blood circulates in all our parts of our body? What is the main organ responsible for blood circulation? It is heart, right? It is heart. So, the main organ of the body which pumps the blood to all the parts of the body is called as heart, okay? The main organ of the body which pumps blood to all the parts of our body is called as heart. Now fold your left hand fingers to make a fist, okay? Make a fist. The size of your heart is almost equal to your left fist, okay? Now, all of you, fold your left hand, okay? Fold your left hand fingers to make a fist. You see the picture and fold your hand. Yes, this is nothing but the size of your heart, okay? This is the size of your heart. You have already learned about the lungs. The heart is located between the lungs, right? Slightly towards the left. Heart is protected by chest cavity. Heart is protected by chest cavity. So the blood circulates to all the parts of our body and it gets impure by receiving carbon. Impure blood enters the heart through the blood vessels. From the heart, this impure blood reaches the lungs. In the lungs, it gives up carbon dioxide and receives oxygen and becomes pure. The pure blood reaches the heart once again through the blood vessels. The pure blood, which has oxygen, reaches all parts of the body through blood vessels. This is blood circulation. Let me explain it to you once again. You see the picture here. So, blood circulates to all parts of our body, right? It gets impure by receiving carbon dioxide. So a parts of a body will have carbon dioxide. So what happens? It gets impure by receiving this carbon dioxide from all the parts of our body. Then this impure blood, now blood is impure by the mixing of carbon dioxide. Then this impure blood enters the heart. Okay, this impure blood enters the heart. You see here, enters the heart. So it enters the heart through blood vessels. From the heart, the impure blood reaches the lungs. Okay, it reaches the lungs. From the heart, it reaches the lungs. Once it reaches the lungs, it gives out the carbon dioxide. And I told you, in lungs, what happens when we respirate? What happens? It absorbs the oxygen. Now, this oxygen from the lungs goes to the heart. Okay, from the lungs, oxygen goes to the heart. So the blood becomes pure in the heart. Then the pure blood reaches the heart once again through the blood vessels. The pure blood, which has oxygen, reaches the all parts of your body through blood vessels. From here it goes to all the parts of your body. This process we call it as blood circulation. How do doctors examine the heartbeat? Have you seen it? You see the picture here. What is this? This is stethoscope. So this is an instrument used by the doctors to know the heartbeat. To know the heartbeat. Write its name. What is its name? It is stethoscope. Write it in your book. It is stethoscope.